Welcome to the Tableau tutorials. In this video, we are going to introduce ourselves or basically make ourselves comfortable with the Tableau public window that is open in front of us. Okay, so we already know that how can we install Tableau public into our systems. That's a really simple process. Also, we know how to connect with the data set, right? However, there are a ton of different things that are available on this welcome screen or on the start page that we first need to take a look at, and then we can just proceed with the data and its workings. Okay, so these things are actually really important if you want to have an in-depth understanding of Tableau public. So the first thing is the chart types. If you want to explore what are the basic chart types available in Tableau public, you can just click on this link and it would take you to this kind of a Tableau public website, which has a video that would tell you all about this, and you can see the different information is present over here, right? So it is kind of like a preparatory course for you. The sample data is also given. If you want, you can just download the data set directly from here. We would be working with some of these data sets as well in this course, so you do not need to worry. And you can see most of the files are Excel files or the CSV files which are supported by Tableau public. Also, there are some community resources, including the challenges which you would be able to compete in once you have got an understanding of Tableau public, right? So these are some of the links, like the overview of the software, about its interface, how to do stuff on Tableau. Next, this is a really important concept or the really important section, and that is the Viz of the Day section. Now, what is this Viz of the Day section? It contains visualizations from the Tableau online community. That means we know Tableau online or Tableau public is available freely online, and whatever visualizations we share, those could be viewed by anyone on the internet, right? So here is the collection of some of the top visualizations submitted by the people all around the globe that have been recognized by the Tableau community for you, so that you can view them. Like, if you just take a look on this first one, if you just click on the link, then this visualization would be loaded. All we needed was just a link that was provided to us, and here you can see that this whole thing is available to us, the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. Everything that you need to know about it, this whole visualization, this whole dashboard, you can see, because there are a couple of visualizations all present together in the same page. So this is a dashboard. It is available in Tableau and it is made in Tableau, right? Now, what all you can do over here is you can just share it. Here is the sharing options. You can share it via the link, or you can embed it in the form of an HTML code. Other options include downloading this visualization and viewing it in full screen. So this is how you can just view it in the full screen for a better understanding. And if you want, you can download it and work with it. So here it is. That's how you can access it. Okay. Now, this is some of the collections of the visualizations which you can just check. Okay. Now, let us just go back to our file. That was the Microsoft Excel file, the sample superstore data. This was all that you need to know about welcome screen, because that's not there's not many things that we need to understand. Okay, now let us understand our data source. This is a sample superstore data source that we would be using throughout this tutorial course, because it has a humongous amount of data and a really important sets of data. Okay, so first of all, what I'm going to do is open it in an Excel file so that you would be able to understand it in a better way. So this is the whole data set that has been opened in Microsoft Excel, and you can take a look at this. The basic things that we are going to understand in Excel is that there are three sheets. First is the orders sheet, second is the people's sheet, and the third is the returns sheet. Okay, so if we talk about orders sheet, it has got a large number of columns. You can see all these columns are present in the order sheet. That is all the data related to the orders. Next we have is the people's sheet. That is which person is in charge of which region, because in the order sheet, the data is divided into regions. Third we have is the returns sheet. That tells us that how many, what was the order ID and was it returned or not. So basically, if a particular order ID is present in this returns sheet, that means it has been returned, because you can see in the returned all the values that we have is of yes. You can just check that. Okay. So apart from this, these are the three sheets. We have three tables as well, as you can see from here. If you just click on this, so this is the orders table. That means all of the data is consolidated together in a table format as well. Similarly, we have people and the returns sheet too. Okay, let's just close this. Right, now we know how the data looks in the real life in Excel actually. Once we have connected this data to Tableau, what happens is we are getting these three tables and three sheets as well. You can see if in the brackets you take a look at, it is called named range. So named range actually refers to the tables part only, because in Excel we can just select a bunch of columns and rows together and give it a name. So that is known as a named range. That's exactly what was done. So these are the three named ranges with these green symbols, and with these simple chart like symbols we have the sheets. Okay, now if you want to extract the data, or if you want to use the data in Tableau, then how do you do that? As we know, Tableau, all the things that Tableau requires is just drag and drop. So suppose we want to work with the orders table, what we can do is, first of all, we can view the data if you want. So click on this icon and it would load the data for you. Right, here is the whole data that has been loaded. If you want, you can just maximize it to get a better look. By default, the total number of rows, that is the 9994 rows, are shown to you. So that is the total number of rows actually present in the data or in this particular table. But if you want, suppose like 20 rows, you can just select 20 and press enter. So what happens, the first 20 rows are now filtered and shown to you. So usually what happens in the case of the large data sets is we don't want to view the whole data set. All we want to do is know that how the data is being organized, what are the columns, etc. This kind of information we can get sufficiently from a smaller number of rows, like say 10-20 rows. So that's how usually we proceed with the things. Okay, and now we can just close it. Similarly, you can do these things for the others or others as well, whether it's a named range or whether it is a sheet. Okay, like suppose we have the people's sheet, so only four rows were there, that's why four rows have been selected over here. Now let's just bring this data into our Tableau. So what we do is we just drag that particular sheet. Suppose you don't want the whole data, you just want a particular sheet, so what you want to do is just drag it and drop it into this portion where it is shown, drag tables here. So you see the orders data has been dragged and it has been loaded as well. So this is a really important part that you need to understand, because it has got a huge amount of information that we can get from the data. Okay, by default 1000 rows are selected. Here also you can just change the number of rows. In case you don't know how many rows are present in the data and you want to get Tableau to show you all the rows, right? So there is a slight trick that's available. What you can do is type a really large number, like right now I have typed in 1 lakh and I press enter. Now what happens, after a few seconds I get 9994. Why? Because that's the largest number of rows that can be present by Tableau, because that's the actual number of rows in the data. Okay, so that's the slight trick that you can do to find out that how many rows are there in your data. Okay, now there are a bunch of things. This is the default option that is selected, that is the preview data source option, right? So in this, what happens, we get a glimpse of the data source, that is how the data is organized, everything related to it. However, there is the second option, that is this manage metadata option. If you remember, in the introduction videos we discussed that how effectively Tableau manages the metadata as well. So this is the metadata section that is available, and as you can see there's a separate section available. So if you want to know about any column, you can just select this particular option and you would be able to know the things like the column name, in which table it is present, and its data type. This hash symbol, this ABC, all refers to the data type. There is a slight code over here that you need to understand, that you need to know for understanding these symbols. So they are really simple to understand. We would be covering them in detail in the next video. because that is all for this video, in which we introduced ourselves with the data source that we would be using, and also we saw that how can we work with the basic operations in Tableau Public.